Oh, ho, ho, look who's back. Me. Yeah. This time I'm playing Audiosurf because I'm done with Dust Force. There's no big change there. They just added a few things that aren't really too noteworthy for me to revisit. So, what you got is what you get. Yeah. So, we're going to start playing. There's different difficulties. Each tier, as you can see, easy, medium, hard. They all have different characteristics of ships that you can play. Now, I haven't really been playing this long enough to be a pro, other than Ninja Mono, which isn't pretty hard. I mean, I'll show you why when we're gonna play this song. But all right, so Audiosurf. The thing is, you pick a song that you want to play. And you play that level that is designed around the song. You know what I'm saying? So you'll see what I mean, because each stage, quote unquote, is different depending on which song that you pick, and each difficulty and each car that you pick is the different play style as well. This one, you just want to try and get all the colored blocks and avoid the gray blocks. Each ship has their own special ability. This one particularly, if you hold a left mouse button, you see the three arrows that pop up. Any colored blocks within the three column range will get picked up. So you don't want to hold on to it, otherwise you get the gray blocks as well. But it's really useful if you see a bunch of colored blocks that you want to get coming up. That way you don't have to frantically go right and left, see, I just, boosh, done. Got all three that I needed, and there you go. So, what happens is, the colors have to be touching in order for them to disappear. So it's kind of like Tetris, but you don't need a line, you just need at least three blocks of the same color touching. So, in different modes, you get different colored blocks, other than just the one in gray in this mode. Hence, Ninja Mono. As a ninja, you're supposed to avoid the gray, and mono is, of course, one color, as you guys would know, because you guys are smart. Ooh! Narrowly avoided that one. Yeah, I think that's pretty much it for the basics of the game. But, I am really enjoying this game so far, especially because it was only like $2.49 on Steam, so I was like, hey! I see a lot of people play it, I'm kind of interested, and I want to get it, so I bought it, and I figured it's something that I could do quick let's plays of, because each song could be a video, so that's how I figured it's how I'm going to do it. And, I really like the song, it's good, I have a bunch of other songs that I want to play. I've only been testing a few songs, so I haven't really played out too much, but all I do know is that jazz is not something that you want to play because the tempo changes. As you can see, I keep slowing down, going quick, and the twisty turny tunnels, the high hills kind of make it sometimes hard for you to know what's going to happen next, so you gotta kind of like keep alert. Playing jazz songs is pretty fun, I'll tell you that much. It's also helpful because it slows down sometimes, but then it also gets very quick, as you can see. And the blocks change color depending on the intensity of the song, I believe. So the hotter the color, the more intense. I think that was my highest score playing this song. So, yep. I hope you enjoyed this video. Next one will be up shortly. And, oh yeah.
Every song has its own high scoreboard.
Shut up.
Here are the top internet scores for this song.
Shut up.
Want to compete?
No.
Log in.
No, I won't. Okay, there's also a high scoreboard, which is pretty cool. You get to see other people who've ever played the same song as you, and I just got 2 achievements. That's pretty cool. Alright, so the next song we'll be playing is going to be Tears. I hope you enjoyed this video. Now, see you guys pretty shortly.